everyone. Welcome to this week's Student Spotlight. I'm Noah Danish here with Senior Sam Hannani. Sam, thank you so much for coming here.
How are you, Mr. Danish?
Doing very well. Thank you so much. So, Sam is a sneakerhead. He buys shoes, sells shoes, and collects shoes. How did you get involved in this, Sam?
So when I was about 13, my cousin came up to me, he's like, yeah, you want to help me get some shoes, and I'll give you some money for it. So I'm like, sure. And then after a couple of times, I saw, wow, it's a profitable business, and I could do it myself. So I went into it myself, and then throughout the years, I gained connections with helping other people, and then they would help me back. So now, right now, we have the Nike HyperAdapt 1.0, Nike's first self-tying shoe. And it sells out within a matter of seconds. Like, it's so hard to get your hands on these, it's almost impossible.
How were you able to get these shoes that we have here?
So throughout the year, since I have my connections, I got in touch with one person I know at Nike, and they were able to secure me a pair of these.
And how do you, I mean, I feel like that's the hard part. How do you get these connections?
So it's pretty hard. You gotta, like, know how to talk to them and get into their head in a way so that you can come close with them. And then once you help them out, they help you out back as a favor.
And how much are these shoes that we have here?
These shoes are $700.
$700. So, I mean, let's kind of show people why $700. So if you see here, if you press this button, it auto-laces the shoes, and then you can untie it by clicking this here. And it's really amazing. And you can see it has these lights here, gives you an indication as to what's happening. These are really amazing. Okay, my question with this is, you have another thing you have to charge at home. How do you do that?
So you bring a charger, so it's a magnetic charger. Technically, it's like wireless because you're putting these wireless pads onto the bottom of the shoe, and it magnetically touches the shoe and charges it for you.
So right here, we put them right here. You can put the charger, and then you just leave them overnight, and they charge for the next day. And these are amazing, and they last you the whole day when you can do the zooming.
Last you about 2 weeks on a full charge.
2 weeks on a full charge. Oh, so you don't have to do it every night. That's really exciting.
It's great.
So these are really great shoes. So HyperAdapts 1.0. And then, so what's your plan with these shoes?
I'm probably going to keep them for my collection since it's like a kind of collector's item and it sells out so quickly. So it wouldn't be fair if I had to sell them because there's no point when you can get such a valuable shoe and keep it for yourself.
Exactly. So what kind of shoes do you have in your collection?
So it varies from tennis shoes to basketball shoes to shoes like these that are self-tying by themselves. It just depends on what I like for myself and what I think has value to sell in the future.
Mm-hmm. And so when you get a shoe, when do you know is the best time to sell it?
So it depends on the shoe. If it's really limited and I find out the stock numbers, I might sell it right then and there if I can get a good price on it. If not, some shoes like the Jordan 1s, they're known for going up in value over years. So I'll keep those in my house, in my storage, and then I'll pull it back out 2 years later, and it'll be worth triple the value.
And how do you know, you're keeping it in your secure storage, how do you keep it, you know, good in there, because it's really valuable storage?
Yeah. So I keep an Excel sheet, and whenever I take something out, I cross it out to let myself know that I don't have it anymore.
That's great. And what avenues do you use to sell these shoes?
I don't use eBay because eBay tends to have a lot of scammers and it doesn't work out really well. Mm-hmm. So there's a website called StockX, which is like a stock market for shoes. And you could place a bid, which is like to buy a shoe, or place an ask to sell the shoe.
And if someone wants to get involved, if they want to become a sneakerhead like you, what's your advice for them?
So start off small and then become big. So work your way up with like a not such a high reselling shoe. Like, start off with a couple of shoes, and then once you get the hang of it, bring other people into it and see if you can make more money.
Is there a risk of losing money in this scenario?
Always. So there could be a shoe, you keep it for like 2 months, and then out of nowhere it'll tank and go under the price you paid. And there's always people who charge more to get it. But it just depends on the shoe and how bad people want it.
Yeah. What's your method of not losing money, I guess? Like, what do you do to make sure that every shoe you buy is going to get you a profit?
So I always keep a track of, like, what every shoe I have in my collection, if it's going up or down. And, like, every week I would check at the end of the week how much the shoe is worth, if it's gone up or down, or if it's coming close to going down. And if it's almost at the point that I bought it for, then I'll just sell it for how much I paid.
And how many transactions are we talking? How many do you do, you know, per week, per month, per year?
Per week, probably 5. Per month, I would say about 20, 30. And per year, I would say over 1,000.
Wow. That's really exciting stuff. That's really exciting stuff. And what are you looking forward to, you know, with these shoes? What are your plans? What are your goals?
So my plan is to keep this shoe and hold it till maybe I'm after college and see if it were to go for, like, at least $3,000. Because from the initial run, they had a set colorway, and I got the colorway. And as soon as I bought it, I sold it for $3,000.
Oh, that's
outside the store. So,
wow. Yeah. So other than shoes, do you buy and sell anything else?
Yeah, so I do shoes, and I also do tickets at home. It's like a little side business. So if, like, say Drake were to come to LA, of course everyone wants to go to his concert. So I'll get front row seats at Drake's concert and flip it for like quadruple the price.
Wow. That's really exciting. And then also, you are one of the presidents of one of these clubs we have on campus, Norman. What is it called?
It's a technology club.
Technology club. And what do you do there?
So technology club, I want to make it so like a forum for people that don't know much about technology, or even if you know a lot about technology, you want to come and learn. So I've brought these in before a couple times for people who missed it to come check it out and see what's the technology behind this shoe, because it's like the Nike Air Max from Back to the Future.
From Back to the Future. This is a similar, so for people who want to, you know, kind of have a comparison, these shoes kind of like the one from Back to the Future. You have the auto lacing that it happens and with the lights, and it's such a cool shoe.
Yeah.
It's like basically for the future. So Sam, thank you so much for coming here, for bringing us. Thank you so much for bringing us these amazing shoes, letting us check it out. These are really amazing shoes. Once again, I'm Noah Donish. Again, Sam, thank you for coming on this week's Student Spotlight. We'll see you next time.